It kind of started it all in a lot of ways. I think that Sabbath was a band that I got into later, and the album that was really important to me was actually Born Again, which was not one of the ones that is typically known as their sort of seminal albums. But I think that any genre that has a figurehead like Sabbath, it sort of hammers home how strange it is to be so divisive and to sort of subjugate all your bands into different genres, you know, like this hardcore scene can't participate with this black metal scene, which can't participate in the new metal scene or the grindcore or whatever. But I think you have a band like that, and it sort of underlines the fact that above and beyond it all, it's just all heavy music, and it's a small genre, and we're all just trying to kind of make a living and become riff lords. So,
even though technically it wasn't billed as Black Sabbath, I had the opportunity to see Heaven and Hell two nights in a row before Dio died, and it changed my life. So I don't think I would be standing here right now had I not been at those shows. I was already a metal fan, I was already a Black Sabbath fan, a fan of the like Dio era stuff, but seeing that in action was just magical, and nothing has ever touched it since then. So,
I mean, of all the greats of the genre, why do you think they're a band that tower so large over everyone else in so many different ways?
Because it was the ultimate amalgam of talent and like sort of like primal spirit. I mean, no one else can capture the same sort of raw, I don't know. They are able to capture like every emotion. Like some of their music's incredibly dark. Some of it is, it leans a little bit more towards like just letting yourself go, losing yourself, finding yourself again inside. I don't know. It was a perfect group of people to be working together. Just, you know, I guess a sort of like primal happenstance in the universe brought the original four members of Black Sabbath together, and there will never be another band like that.
You know, for me, I just remember when the first album came out, I was a kid. I'd never heard anything like that. I'd never seen artwork like that. It just, you know, once I got past all my friends going, oh, that's really scary, it freaks me out, it didn't do that to me. It really kind of drew me in, lyrically, certainly sonically. I mean, Iommi influenced all of us. Any guitar player that walks through here and says that Tony Iommi wasn't an influence is a liar. Because he influenced all of us, man. He's just the greatest of all time, so it's special.
I would just say they brought a whole new different way of playing the blues.
They pretty much started heavy metal. They're one of the greatest heavy metal bands of all time, and they have loads of riffs, which is class.
When I was at school, I was saying before, I failed music because the teacher would say, can you read music? And I'd say, no, music is not meant to be read, it's meant to be heard, it's meant to be played. And one of the first riffs I ever learned to play was Paranoid. So it was a lot more fun to learn how to play Paranoid than it was to play Greensleeves or Christmas Carols.
Oh, Sabbath is one of the first bands I ever heard in my life. My dad's a metalhead, so that's his jam. Sabbath is his jam. So I've heard this since I was a wee kid. And they've been following me up until this day. And I mean, we've been fortunate enough to tour with them. We did Ozfest in the US with them a bunch of years ago. It's just one of those bands that it's so iconic, it's so classic, it's so genre-defining and inspirational to generations, actually. Not only one, but several generations. So it couldn't be more appropriate than to celebrate these guys today.
He invented everything when it comes to that kind of music, you know?
Because he's the best, he's and the awesome. Riffs are the coolest. And
he's got all the fringe.
Ozzy Osbourne.
He's got the
cool.
Big cross.
Black Sabbath is the best.
He invented heavy metal. He's the lord of it. It's the riff lord. They ooze out of
he's
him.
He's the deity.
Yeah, it's the essence of heavy metal. It's Tony Iommi.
Well, I would say that they were, you know, the founding fathers in a way, and I think that all new bands and bands in general paid their respects for a reason, you know. I remember hearing it the first time myself. The darkest, heaviest shit I've ever heard, and I couldn't fucking believe, where does this sound come from? And that was Sabbath. So they were you know, we owe them a lot, and I think every band in this genre do, absolutely. So, yeah.
Tony Iommi's here. Oh, my God. Oh, my God, Tony Iommi. No, I mean, Sabbath, they invented this stuff, you know. I mean, it wasn't for them. Anything I say now is been said before, so I just say it's amazing. It's amazing. I mean, how can you not like Sabbath?
It's the songs. I mean, how can you argue with the Riffmeister? And you know, you can't argue with that shit. It's timeless.
Ozzy will sing a line, and the whole arena will sing the next line. You know, there's nothing like that. I mean, loud, so everybody knows the words. You know, and like you said, not just metal fans. So, I watched the Ozzy movie that the Sun did, and Paul McCartney's talking about how, you know, they're great, they were, and they went into an area of like chords and music and that nobody went to at that time. It was really deep and really heavy and really dark, and I think that really opened the path for those of us who grew up like that, you know, and grew up with those types of things. We all identified with Sabbath very much so.
Well, I mean, the fact is they're done, and they are the pioneers, and they're all still alive. I've been a huge Ozzy fan since 1981, when I was 10 years old, growing up in Winnipeg, Canada. It might be per capita the biggest Ozzy fan base ever. And then getting to know Tony over the years and meeting Geezer and Bill Ward, the respect we all have for him, and also with Ronnie Dio, you know, and Vinny Appice, the Sabbath family is, I mean, that is the, it's all, I mean, let's be honest, it's based around Tony's riffs and Ozzy's voice. And Tony's riffs and Dio's voice, and Tony's riffs and anybody else that sang with him. But Tony Iommi is the pioneer of heavy metal. And to have him here tonight at an awards show that was this close to being just completely canceled, to me it's a huge victory. Because we didn't get, you know, Lars. We didn't get Steve Harris. We didn't get, I don't know, Nikki Sixx. We got Tony Iommi, the godfather, the pioneer, almost the father of heavy metal, and he was here tonight to praise the style of music and praise all of its fans. That to me is a once in a lifetime event.
It's an absolute honor to have you here with us tonight. I guess the obvious question of all the magnificent awards that's been heaped upon you in your illustrious career, what does this specific one tonight mean to you?
Well, I think it's great, and it's great for this sort of music and the heavy metal, you know, and rock. I think it's a great award, really. It means a lot because it goes with what we do. How do you explain it? It's a feeling inside that is, you know, it's power and heavy metal. But I think with Metal Hammer, it's sort of, you know, this magazine, it supported our sort of music and really done a lot for it, you know. And this award will mean a lot. Yeah, I think it's nice. I mean, it's nice to see the fans. It's always nice to see the fans, and it's a great honour that I can come here and see them. You know, they've supported us all these years, and it is weird after coming off the tour and not doing anything for a bit now, and then suddenly coming back again. It's a bit of a shock.
I mean, obviously it was a spectacular and emotional experience for fans watching that tour and watching those final shows. Can you talk about your emotions on stage while that was happening and now with a little bit of distance?
Yeah, I think the whole tour was, for us, was great, but the last shows were, because we knew they were going to be the last shows, it didn't quite sink in properly until sort of afterwards, you know. And even afterwards, because we done 3 days of filming after that for the DVD, so we were still together. But after the 3 days of filming, that was weird, because we were saying goodbye to each other, and it was like really strange. You know? But to see the crowd on those last shows was spectacular. You know, you saw there's people from all over the world, and all the emotions coming out in them, and you could see it from where we were. Yeah, fantastic. A lot of we've done some great shows, you know, and things stick in your mind, like California Jam sticks in my mind. Madison Square Garden's the first time we ever played there. Shows like that. they're just, you know, there's just events that were great, you know. But we've had so many, and it's to name them would be impossible. Every gig you do is an event, really. And certainly on the last tour, I loved it. I mean, I loved doing all the shows. I loved the crowd. Brilliant. And it's got stronger and stronger. That's the thing. It's ironic, isn't it, that it's got so strong and powerful. And now we're packed up. But, you know.
How proud are you of the impact you've had on the genre, and what do you think of the current state of it when you see the acts that are performing here tonight?
Very proud of it. Very proud of it. And it's great. And as I say, like, you know, with Metal Hammer and things like Download and stuff, keeps the music alive, and that's what it's got to do. It's got to keep it alive. And bands like tonight are what keep it alive.
What do you think the future of the genre is? Because obviously we're seeing it being pulled and pushed in various different directions at the moment.
I think it's good, you know, and there's some great bands around now, and you've got bands like Metallica, and they're going out full blast, and I love it. I love to see it. Well, they've done so much for us, the fans, and I'd like to thank them very, very much, and I want them to sort of keep this music alive, because it really is real music, you know, and the love of it for them and the love of it for us has been just so great. I mean, that's why I've stuck with it all these years, because I love what we do. I love this sort of music.